& Bloom News Brief. More info at fullandbloom.com. In a recent interview with Ultimate Guitar, Twisted Sister guitarist JJ French talked about the time he auditioned for Kiss back in the early 70s. On meeting Gene Simmons and Paul Stanley. If you're talking about Gene Simmons as a person who has a reputation of being an arrogant, self-absorbed human being, that's probably how he was back then, too. But to be fair, I was 20 when I met them, and they were 22, Gene and Paul Stanley. I met them together, and they were the first people I ever met who had an idea of who they were. Up until then, all the musicians were just hippie musicians I played with. Nobody said, this is the plan that we have. When I met Gene and Paul, they had this plan. I only met them because they already had a record deal on Epic Records with Wicked Lester. And the producer's lawyer, I used to babysit for his daughter, so he kind of got me an audition. He said, you're looking for a band. He said that in the elevator one day to me, like, hey, you're looking for a band? Why, because I have long hair and I play guitar all day long and you can hear me play in the building? Yeah. He goes, want to audition for a band? And I went, sure. So when Gene and Paul came down to meet me for the first time, Gene was pretty, are you Jewish? You're Jewish, right? Well, we're gonna change our names. We're Jews too. You look too Jewish. No one had ever said to me at this point in my life, especially another Jew, had ever asked me if I was Jewish or that it mattered, or that my name mattered, or that my image mattered. This was Gene. Now, obviously, Gene and Paul had decided at this point that they were going to break up this band called Wicked Lester to do this other thing, which became Kiss. They just said to me, the demo you got, we're gonna break that band up, we're gonna start all over. But they didn't talk about makeup. They just said, like, we're gonna be heavy, we're gonna wear platform shoes, because platform shoes were just starting to come out, you know. This was 1972. The Allman Brothers, Grateful Dead were hippie, but I kinda sensed this was changing. The vibe was changing, the scene was changing, and I was changing. So I looked forward to it. It was like a new adventure. I rehearsed with them a couple of times and it was nice. We played Zeppelin songs, we did Jimi Hendrix. We were very influenced by the same music. Hendrix, Zeppelin, Beatles, we were all the same age. Pink Floyd, The Who, that was all a part of who we all were. And then it didn't work out. They stopped calling me, which was fine, and 4 months later, they were still advertising in the local paper, and I was looking for a band still, and I called the ad. It was Gene, and he said, no, no, we found a guitar player, and that was Ace. He said, but after we're done rehearsing for a while, you can come down and see the band. So I went down and saw them in October of 72. To put this in perspective, you know who the New York Dolls are, obviously. I don't know what you think of the New York Dolls, but it was a band of musicians floating around New York City that were not necessarily thought of as good musicians. And so in September of 72, I went to see them because friends of mine knew them very well. And I just thought they were terrible. Apparently, Gene and Paul saw them at the same time. I have a magazine called Rock Scene Magazine from 1973, and New York Dolls are on the cover, and Twisted Sister and Kiss are in little black and white photos inside saying, these are the bands that are coming, which is kind of interesting if you think about it. But when I went down to see Kiss rehearse with Ace as Kiss, they just changed their name. It was impressive. It was like they knew exactly what they wanted to do. I had never met people that focused before. So it was interesting to see those guys, and it doesn't surprise me how successful they got because they were that focused. To read the entire segment, click the link in the description.